Hello everybody, so in this video we are going to learn how to make a BCG matrix using bubble charts. You might have seen my other video about creating a perceptual map using Excel as well. So in this video we are going to talk about creating a BCG matrix using Excel. So the numbers and the company of course is going to be completely hypothetical and I'm just going to make up things as I go along. So as we know, when we talk about the BCG matrix, it's a portfolio analysis matrix. A company uses a portfolio analysis matrix such as the BCG matrix to figure out how its future outlook is and how to allocate resources between its different business units. To learn more about the BCG matrix, please watch my other video that talks about this in more detail. This is just to show you how to make a BCG matrix in Excel. So that's what I'm going to do here. So let's just imagine a company that has a lot of different strategic business units. So for this purpose, let's say there's a company that has a women's care division, right? It also has, let's say, men's care division. And then let's say it has a food and beverage division as well. Since this is just example, right? So food and beverage division as well. Let's say that it has a cell phone division, and then also, just for example's purpose, let's say that this particular company also sells cars, right? So just for example, so these are just some random SBUs that I've chosen, right? So now let's see that there are five, as we can see here, there are five different strategic business units within that particular company. So let's just take for example's purpose that the sales for each of those division for 2020, which is last year, is, let's say, $8,000 for women's care. For men's care, let's say it is $1,500. Let's say for the food and beverage division, it's like $3,000. For the cell phone division, let's say it's $750. And for cars, let's say it's $15,000. So of course, in terms of the strategic business units, the cars division is the biggest division, right? And let's just also take a look at its biggest competitor sales. So here what we can look at is, because the BCG matrix, on the x-axis you have relative market share, where you compare the market share of your company with that of your nearest competitor, and on the y-axis we have the market growth rate, right? So to calculate relative market share, we also need the market, or we also need the market numbers for its closest competitor. So for example, let's say for the women's care division, the nearest competitor's sales is 26,000. So we see, let's say for example's purpose, to make it easier, let's say it's 24,000, right? So we can see that our sales are like one third the sales of our nearest competitor. So we are not as big as our nearest rival, right? So our share is not as big as the biggest rival that we have for this particular industry. For men's care, let's say that the overall sale is 3,000. So we are kind of like much closer to our competitors when it comes to men's care versus women's care. In the food and beverage division, let's say that we are the biggest company, right? And our nearest competitor is half the size that we have. And in the cell phone industry, let's say again, we are quite big, right? So 750 compared to our nearest competitor, who is 400. And then in the cars division, for example purpose, let's say that our nearest competitor is 50,000. So we are not as of a big player in the cars division as the biggest player in that field. So now what we can do is we can calculate our relative market share, right? So our relative market share compared to our competitor. So to calculate relative market share, what we are going to do is, let's see, what is the total? So let's just calculate all the totals as well. Equals to the sum of all of this, right? So this is the total sales for our company for 2020, and it comprises of all the different sales for this. So our relative market share compared to our nearest competitor is 8,000 divided by 24,000. And since we want it in terms of percentages, for example, so it's like 33% of our closest rival, we can just drag and drop this here to see that it's like 50%. This is 200% because our nearest or the biggest competitor is 1500 while we are 3000. So we have a very high relative market share compared to our competitor, right? So let's just try to make this a little bit better in terms of looks, right? So sales for 2020, competitors, relative market share is this number. And then the next title that we should have is the other part is associated with the growth rate, right? So x-axis is relative market share. So this is one that we are interested in, which will be our x-axis, and our y-axis will be here, which is talking about industry growth rate. So when we look at the industry growth rate, let's just say that the women's care is not growing as rapidly and the growth rate is only 2%. The men's care is kind of growing at an average of 10%. So the men's care is growing at 10%, let's say, which is quite a big growth, right? So an industry growing by 10% is a really good industry where you would want to be in. Let's talk about the food and beverage division and imagine that it's growing at 5%. And then we have the cell phone industry, let's say it's growing at the fastest rate, which is 13%. And then for a moment, imagine that the car sales, the automobile industry is not doing so well. So maybe it's growing at 1%, right? So, and these are all just hypothetical number, as I said. So if we look at the sales, we can see that these are all the different SBUs for our company, right? These are the sales. Now our total sales is 28,000, of which 15,000 is coming from cars. So of course this is a really, really important division for our company, just as this is as well. So this is almost like half of our company, this is almost 1/4 of our company, right? So we need to also figure out which strategic business unit is important to us, and that can also be represented on the BCG matrix, right? So for that, what we are going to do is let's calculate SBU share, right? So this will be represented as the bubble size, which will also be represented in the BCG matrix. So the SBU share is simply going to be 8,000 divided by our total, and since I want to put it here, it's like 28,250, right? So that's our total share. So we can see that it's 28% of our business is in women's care, right? So if we just do this, we see that cars is like this particular strategic business unit is provides almost 53% of our revenue. So it's a very, very important division for us as well. So we can see that it totals to 100%, right? So this will also be a part of our BCG matrix, so we'll just highlight it. Now as we said, for the BCG matrix we have x-axis, which will be relative market share, we have y-axis, which will be the industry growth rate, and then the bubble size itself will kind of represent the strategic business unit share for our particular company. So to create a BCG matrix using a bubble chart, let's just start by clicking in a random box that is empty because we don't want Excel to input the data automatically. We want to enter it on our own, right? So let's click on insert, and then we see a lot of different charts here. We are going to of course use the bubble chart as we already mentioned, right? So since no data is selected, this is right now empty. We can use select data, click here, or we can just right click on this to select data as well, right? So right click on this and then we select data. Now we can individually add all the bubbles that we want, which is basically going to be all the strategic business that we want to incorporate in our BCG matrix. So women's care, our x-axis data, the y-axis data, and how important that particular strategic business unit is in terms of the bubble size, right? So women's care is added. We want to add men's care as another series. This is the x-axis for men's care, this is the y-axis for men's care, and this is going to be the bubble size. And then again, we want to add food and beverage. This is going to be the x-axis for food and beverage. This is going to be the y-axis for food and beverage, and then the bubble size. Now, you might remember that we used a scatter plot to create a perceptual map. You could also use a bubble chart to create a perceptual map as well. And for that, you would follow a process like the one that we are following here right now. And that's very, very similar as well. Now, the last SBU, of course, for us is going to be cars, x-axis for cars, the y-axis for cars, and then the bubble size is going to be pretty huge because this is one of the biggest SBU for us, right? So we'll click on this. Now we can see that this is the final BCG matrix chart that we have created. It's not final because we want to make this look like a BCG matrix. Now, let's just make this look like a BCG matrix, which will require some manual tinkering. Like I just selected the axis and I'm going to delete the axis, right? And then what I want to do is, again, I want to move this axis as kind of like in the center. So I can just click here, and then because I want to work with the axes, I click on the plus sign here, and then I have axes. When I click more options, it will bring up this table where I want to work with the axis options. Right now it's going from -50 to 250. If you look here, I want it to go from 0 to 250 for example's purpose here, right? And then what I want to do is for this axis to cut in the middle, right? So right now the axis value is 0. What I want to do is I want from 0 to 250 so that this cuts at 125. So now we can see that this moved to the center. Again, I can do the same for this axis as well. What I want is for this axis to move to the center, right? So again, click on it. We'll see the axis options. It goes from -0.2% to 16%. If I change this to 0, what's going to happen is that it will cut this off here. So this circle will kind of like become a semicircle, right? So that's the only reason I'm not removing this. So let's just show you what will happen. So if I make this 0, we'll see that the chart is cut off at 0, right? But I don't want that to happen because my chart is now not looking as good as I want it to look. So I'll just go from 2% to 16%. Now, what I want to do is for the middle axis to cut between 2% and 16%. So again, in the value, what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep it between 16 and -2, which is going to be 18, so 0.09. for now, right? So if I put it like this, so let's put it at 0.07 so that it looks at the center, right? So here we can see that now this kind of looks like a BCG matrix, but again, it doesn't look like a BCG matrix because we have no titles or headers or anything like that, and we have these numbers that are visible, which generally is not visible whenever we're looking at a BCG matrix. So we can just try to remove this. This is everything to do with the labels, right? So here if I click on this, I see in this box that there is labels. In the labels it says next to axis, I want to say none. And then again, select this, it's also showing as next to axis, I want to say select none. Now what I also want to do is I want to make sure people understand what the x-axis and y-axis are all about. So I can just insert a text box and then label those, which is RE relative market share on the y-axis, because that's what it is, right? Sorry, on the x-axis, and on the y-axis also I want to insert the name, and this is going to be market. For simplicity, let's just put market GRWT growth rate, right? So we can see that this is market growth rate and this is relative market share. So now what we can see here, but just by looking at this, we can see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different strategic business units that are scattered all across the BCG matrix. Now, to do the proper analysis, we need to figure out which strategic business unit this is. So we need to label it. And also we can see here that the relative size of the bubbles show how important that particular strategic business unit is for us. So the biggest strategic business unit that we can see here is associated with cars, because they provide like more than 50%. So in this case, 53% of our revenue, right? So 53% of our revenue is coming from the cars division. That's why the bubble is really, really big. And this is a very important strategic business unit for us. Whereas if you look at this, this is the cell phone strategic business unit. And then it's very, very small, because this provides the smallest percentage of revenue, which is only like 2.65% of our revenue is coming from the cell phone division, right? So this, although is making us some money, it's not a really big part in terms of how much money it makes for us. So we also want to now label these, right? So what we can do is we can click on this. We want the data labels to be visible, right? So we can click here for labels and then start creating labels. So label options, right now it's showing the Y value 13%, right? So here 13%, this is growing at 1%. So it's showing us the Y axis value. We don't want, so if we click on the X axis value, it will show us the both X axis as well as the Y axis. Now we don't want the X axis or the Y axis. What we want is the series name, right? So if we click on the series name, it's showing us that this is the women's care division. Now for this bubble, we again want to remove everything and we just want the series name. For this bubble, it's right now, sorry, for this bubble, it's not right now showing us the Y axis value. We want to replace it by the name. Again, this 13%, we want to replace it by the name. So it's the cell phone division. This 5%, we want to replace it by the series name. So now here we can see the BCG matrix, right, for each of the strategic business units that we have here. So the cell phone division is this, the men's care, the women's care, the cars division, food and beverage division. And of course, by looking at this, we can see that the future for this company does not look really, really good, because we know that this is a section that is dogs, right? So this is relative market share, this is market growth rate. So the higher up you are, the better you are, right? So what we can see here is that if we think about the BCG matrix, this is the dogs, and you don't want the biggest strategic business unit for your company to be in the dogs. So the future growth is going to come from the cell phone division, but the cell phone division is such a small part of your entire business. It only represents 2%. The second largest growth opportunity for you is the men's care, right? But the men's care right now is in the question mark. So this is going to be the dogs, this is question mark, this is stars, and this is the cash cow division, right? So here we can see that this is question mark. So to understand and talk about that in more detail, please take a look at my BCG matrix video. This video is only for us to understand how to create a BCG matrix, right, in Excel. And I think through this video you have learned to do that. So please let me know if you have any questions or concerns. Thank you very much for watching. Take care. Bye.